So no doubt you've heard about the 4-day work week, but what about the 4-day school week? In classrooms coast to coast, many devoted teachers are just burned out right now. Now a school system in Ohio is switching to a 4-day school week where students will be in class Tuesday through Friday. Mondays are for self-guided work at home while teachers have a day for lesson planning.
We really dig deep. This is about student achievement. And if our teachers aren't 100%, then our students won't get what they truly need and deserve.
So among parents, there's a lot of support, but as you can imagine, some hesitation as well. This new schedule will start in August with new options to help parents with childcare needs and reduced meal compensation. That was my concern. You know, how would parents deal with having their kid home that day during the week?
Because it's a juggling act.
It is, no doubt. Now to a big change in Minnesota, which will affect every baby born in the state. Minnesota is the first in the country to universally screen newborns for a little-known virus, which can have significant health impacts.
This morning, a first-hand look at how it works and why some say this early intervention is key.
At barely 24 hours old, baby Nayer is getting his blood spotted for the state's newborn screening panel.
Sorry.
A single prick on his foot, marking a big step in children's health. Nayer's blood spots, along with those of every Minnesota newborn, come here, a lab at the Department of Health. The newborn screening panel has long looked for more than 60 conditions in newborns, and is now the first in the country to also look for something new, congenital cytomegalovirus, a common infection often going undetected. But if a pregnant woman gets it, it can have devastating effects on the developing baby.
I happened to get it for the first time when I was pregnant with Vivian. And so that's where it transmitted to the baby, it transmitted to her.
Leah Henriksen's now 8-year-old daughter Vivian has hearing loss, cerebral palsy, and epilepsy after getting CMV in utero. She's the inspiration behind the Vivian Act, a law passed in 2021, paving the way for universal newborn screening for CMV.
What difference does that make to know right away?
It makes all the difference in the world to know right away. Early is always better for treatment. But if you don't know, you can't treat what you don't know. So then, you know, you've missed your window, and that it's hard to make up that valuable time.
During these precious first moments in the hospital, it's too soon to know Nayer's results. But if needed, he and his family will now have the gift of time.
So the Department of Health says of the, say, 65,000 babies born every year in Minnesota, about up to 300 will be born with CMV. And then of that number, only 20% will develop symptoms, but still certainly a big consequences for the families that do.
Yeah, no doubt. A big component of the Vivian Act is about education for CMV. Many women have never even heard of the virus, let alone know how it spreads through bodily fluid or saliva, but the word is getting out there.
Yeah, big deal if you're pregnant and you're sharing food with your maybe older children. Mm-hmm. That's a really common way that can spread. So that's why that education component is so important.
So crucial.
Yeah.